keep you here, Steve, is Steve, there in particular, what do you make of the possibility of that 50 basis point rate hike, at least potentially on the table, if the market is giving the opportunity to consider it?
Yeah, I think Steve just made an excellent point. And, you know, when I blend what he said with what Shannon said, which is basically, you know, it's the number of rate hikes that's going to matter, it suddenly dawns on me, it should have dawned on me earlier, that this market is likely to rip, the stock market, that is, on March 16th. And the reason is because this is like ripping the Band-Aid off, or this is like taking a dive into a beautiful mountain lake that's cold. You know, when it first happens, it's shocking, and then the body adjusts, and that's what's going to happen. And frankly, I agree with Steve. You know, the market's giving the Fed cover. I think they're clearly behind. I mean, the fact that everybody thought this print was going to be lighter than expectations and it came in the hottest since whenever, I think they have to come out with a 50 basis point hike. They've got the cover to do it. Rip the Band-Aid off. Let's dive into the beautiful mountain lake, because you know what? The market's going to be fine. It's just going to be kind of this nail-biting, annoying, and tantalizing moment for the next 4 weeks.
Can I just make one quick point here, which is that the market is, the Fed is behind if you look at the real rates, which are still deeply negative. But I have a spreadsheet on my computer here that updates automatically every time a price changes. We have 100 basis points of tightening in the 2-year yield from the time that Powell pivoted on the 30th of November to the beginning of the 29th. So it is interesting. The market has taken that, it's already in there. The Fed is going to raise rates in order to catch up with where the market is. But the market has done a lot of tightening for the Fed. There's an awful lot of tightening in the market already that should, I mean, the hope is it slows the economy down and does in the second half get a handle on inflation. So I just want to make that point that there's a lot of tightening in the market already.
Let me say one thing to that, Steve. I'll just make it quick, which is that I get your point. I have to say I'm a little worried about the 2-year, and I'm a little worried about the curve flattening that's gone on for the last several weeks, because the bond market is screaming that the Fed's going to get this wrong. And I don't know that that's true or not, but that's what the bond market is screaming, not just hinting, screaming.
Well, I'll go ahead and jump in here. What do you make of the idea of potentially us jumping into this cold water pool that feels shocking, but then sort of gets us to a more comfortable place?
I think maybe this Fed would be worried too much about the consequences of being wrong, even if the market presents that opportunity. And so my sense is that they probably should be doing that, but the market wouldn't react very favorably necessarily to that, and they need that to be a necessarily favorable reaction that allows them to continue with their mandate, which is to tighten policy. I think if you look at every survey, the thing that's going to derail this economy is this: if inflationary pressures slow down consumers. If it's business, if it's consumers, whoever you talk to, they're worried about inflation. And so priority number one for economic health is dealing with the inflation problem. Now, I don't think you need to rip off the Band-Aid to do that. I think you can probably do that with some thoughtful telegraphing and saying that you're data dependent. And my sense is the data will continue to support the fact that they should continue to tighten. So I don't agree that they need to rip it off.
Mr. Leisman, Steve, thank you very much for being here with us. We are now letting you go get back to your business. Protection strategies from the committee right now. Brent, I want to start with exposure to